socialization.
Socialization. Socialization.
Socialization.
Socialization.
Did you know, if parents prevent their children from going out of the house to interact or to play with other children, they will grow to become ignorant? Children, even at a very young age, must need to interact and play with other children for them to boost their confidence, to make them feel that they belong, and to mingle and socialize with different people in the community. Social experience, the key to our humanity. Without social experience, a human being is incapable of thought, emotion, or meaningful action, seeming more an object than a person. Socialization. It refers to the lifelong social experience by which individuals develop their human potential and learn about culture. What is personality? Social experience is also the basis of personality. A person's fairly consistent patterns of acting, thinking, and feeling. Human development. Nurture and nature. Humans depend on others to provide the care needed, not only for physical growth, but for personality to develop. According to Charles Darwin and his study of evolution, it claims that members of technologically simple societies were biologically less evolved and therefore less human. And psychologist John B. Watson and his theory of behaviorism held that behavior is not instinctive but learned. People everywhere are equally human, differing only in their cultural patterns. In short, Watson rooted human behavior not in nature but in nurture. However, whether you realize an inherited potential depends on your chance to develop. More precisely, nurture is our nature.
H. Erickson's 8 stages of development. Stage 1, infancy. Between birth and about 18 months, infants face the first of life's challenges to gain a sense of trust that their world is a safe place. Family members play a key role and how any infant meets this challenge. Stage 2, toddlerhood. The next challenge up to age 3 is to learn skills to cope with the world in a confident way. Failure to gain self-control leads children to doubt their abilities. Stage 3, preschool. 4 and 5 years old must learn to engage their surroundings, including people outside the family, or experience guilt at having failed to meet the expectations of parents and others. Stage 4, pre-adolescence. Between ages 6 and 13, children enter school, make friends, and strike out on their own more and more. They feel proud of their accomplishments or, at times, fear that they do not measure up. Stage 5, adolescence. During the teenage years, young people struggle to establish their own identity. All teens experience some confusion as they struggle to establish an identity. Stage 6, young adulthood. The challenge for young adults is to form and keep intimate relationships with others. Falling in love involves balancing the need to bond with the need to have a separate identity. Stage 7, middle adulthood. The challenge of middle age is to contribute to the lives of others in the family, at work, and in the larger world. Stage 8, old age. Near the end of their lives, people hope to look back on what they have accomplished with a sense of integrity and satisfaction. For those who have been self-absorbed, old age brings only a sense of despair over missed opportunities.
Can you blow my whistle, baby, let me know. Girl, I'm gonna show you how to do it and we start real slow. You just put your lips together and you come real close. Can you blow?
Masaha. World. Childhood. Pangitaon Pilipinas.
Kani?
Lili. Juan, muna siyang tao. Ang forma.
Tao. Kani? Mama ni siyang tao.
Lili, mapa man, mapa.
No!
Come on!
socialization and the life course. Childhood. Although childhood has special importance to socialization, this process continues throughout our lives. The whole idea of childhood is fairly new. In the Middle Ages, children of 4 or 5 were treated like adults and expected to take care of themselves. We defend our idea of childhood because youngsters are biologically immature. But a look back in time and around the world shows that the concept of childhood is grounded not in biology, but in culture. Adolescence emerges as a buffer between childhood and adulthood. We generally link adolescence or the teenage years with emotional and social turmoil as young people develop their own identities. Again, we are tempted to attribute teenage turbulence to the biological changes of puberty, but this turmoil more correctly reflects cultural inconsistency. For example, the mass media glorifies sex, and schools hand out condoms, even as parents urge restraint. Consider too that an 18-year-old may face the adult duty of going to war, but lacks the adult right to drink alcohol. In short, adolescence is a time of social contradictions when people are no longer children, but not yet adults. You can rock.
Adulthood is a time of life when most accomplishments occur, such as pursuing careers, raising families. Personalities are largely formed, although marked change in a person's environment, such as unemployment, divorce, or serious illness in which may result in a significant change to the self. During early adulthood until at the age of 40, young adults learn to manage day-to-day affairs to themselves, often juggling conflicting priorities such as parents, partners, children, schooling, and work. In the middle adulthood, between the ages 40 and 60, people sense that their circumstances are pretty well set. They become more conscious about their health, like exercising. Also, in the middle adulthood, parents, especially mothers, become more emotional as their children growing up, having a different life and become more independent. It also occurs in the middle adulthood that most women experience divorce with their husband. Most women in the middle adulthood seek new careers due to some circumstances.
Old age. The later years of adulthood and the final stage of life begins about the mid-60s. With people living longer, the elderly population is growing nearly as fast as the U.S. But perhaps most important, elderly people will be more visible in everyday life. In the 21st century, the young and the old will interact far more. The aging of the U.S. population is one focus of gerontology, from the Greek word geron, meaning old person. The study of aging and elderly. Gerontologists study both the physical and social dimensions of growing old. Aging and biology. For most of our population, gray hair, wrinkles, and declining energy begin in the middle age. After about age 50, bones become more brittle, injuries take longer to heal, and the risk of chronic illness such as arthritis and diabetes, and life-threatening conditions such as heart disease and cancer rise steadily. Sensory abilities, taste, sight, touch, smell, and especially hearing become less sharp with age. Aging and culture. Culture shapes how we understand growing old. A pre-industrial society then usually takes the form of a gerontocracy, a form of social organization in which the elderly have the most wealth, power, and prestige. Industrialization lessens the social standing of the elderly. A problem of technologically advanced societies, then, is ageism, prejudice and discrimination against older people. All technology and new technology. In old age, by contrast, aging means leaving behind roles that have provided social identity and prestige. Removed from familiar work routines, some people view retirement as restful reaction, but others lose their self-worth and suffer outright boredom. Reaching old age also means living with less income.
Not responding to any questions that we are giving you. I'm sorry, but you have only 2 weeks to live.
2 weeks, Doc? Lali lang yung pamahagyan na.
I'm so sorry.
Naka man siguro na, Doc. Hindi, ngayon. Doc, naka pa man na, naka palagi na. Sige na, Doc. Naka palagi na.
Wala ng lubusan. dawat na lang dyan na ako nga. 2 weeks na lang kinabuhi dito sa kalibutan.
Yeah. Resocialization. It is the process of being retrained to function within a new society. Where do we find resocialization? We find them voluntarily, in religious conversion, those who move to a new country and adopting and joining the military. Others are involuntary, those who we find in prison, those having mandatory counseling, and those who are in drug rehabilitation centers. What happens in resocialization under a total institution? The goal is to drastically change a person's identity, and it has a two-step process. First, part of a person's identity must be erased or reprogrammed. Second, that part must be replaced with an institutionally created one. There are a number of ways of how is it built, such as uniform appearance, humiliation, rename, rewards and punishments, expectation of conformity, and encouragement. But is it effective? Some people may respond well and become rehabilitated. Others may respond in other ways and become hostile. They can create dependency on the institution, such as inmates who, upon release, commit a crime in order to go back to jail as it is the only life they know, and they are unable to resocialize outside of prisons.